This is a log periodic array broadband antenna with a large spectrum depending on the size of the longest elements and the shortest elements, and in fact there are several dipoles. As you can see, there are dipoles, and one is fed from one side of the one boom and the other is fed from the other side of the other boom. In fact, these two booms that are parallel, they are now made like a mummy. They form an open transmission line. So in fact the coaxial cable is coming from this end connector through one boom, and the end is soldered to the other boom.
More schematical view. You see the lower boom, you see the upper boom, some mechanical spacer to keep at least distance, and the coax cable is coming from this connector through one boom, and at the end the center pin is connected to the other boom. The shielding of the coax is connected here and connected here. And as you can see, the elements are on this side and some further on the other boom, and then some further on the other boom, etc. So what you see here is also here, but to the other direction. So they form a dipole, they form a dipole, they form a dipole, etc.
For every frequency, only a few elements are operational. So for the lowest frequency, these are operational, and the rest doesn't matter. And for the higher frequencies, for example, these three, and more higher frequencies, those three, or maybe four. This specific LPA is intended to be used for a parabolic dish in the center, but as you can see, only one point can be in the center. It's the best to take the highest frequencies in the center, because with respect to the wavelength you have more deviation. For the higher frequencies than for the lower frequencies. Why I made it a mummy is because of water ingress. These are two elements, two booms. Between those two booms is always water coming, is in case of rain. So I made the mummy of it with Teflon tape, and over this I do vulcanized tape, and it can withstand rain much better. Another possibility is put a plastic plate on top with some tie wraps or so.
Simulations predict a lot, but what is measured in the real world? As you can see, the spectrum here is from 1 GHz to 4 GHz. So roughly 300 megahertz per division, and this is the standing wave ratio. And as you see, if we take a standing wave ratio of 2, it's not always lower than 2. It is sometimes even going to 3. What you can see is that it starts here just above 1 gigahertz and it goes till more than 3.7 GHz. Here you see the markers. Marker 1 is 1280 MHz, so it's in the 23 centimeter band. Marker 2 is in the 13 centimeter band, so it's already rather high. And this is in the 9 centimeter band. It's also not too low. It could have been better here and here and here. But this is fact, this is measured by a professional instrument operated by a professional engineer.
Log periodic array.